everybody, Mobius Y here. Welcome back to Mass Effect. So in the last episode, we cleared out the Exogeny headquarters on Feros, and we discovered what the Geth are after. They're after a plant-like creature called the Thorian, which has infected the Zeus Hope colonists and is basically making them work for it, sort of. That's why they were behaving strangely, and that's why they were exhibiting pain whenever they were trying to tell us what was really going on. Thorian didn't want us knowing to start things off. So we're heading back there. The colonists have been going a little bit psycho. They've been kind of attacking Normandy a little bit. So we're going to have to go back and deal with them as well as this Thorian creature. I'm playing like a potato right now. Getting absolutely blessed in the Mako. And I did not mean to shoot that gas juggernaut, but I did anyway. Because, hey, we're not. Run this guy over. Off you go. You're dead. This is why the Mako is fun. You can just cheese it up. Run people over. Don't even worry about shooting them. Just run somebody over. Disable them. Blow them up. You know, good times. Alright, so we gotta hit this skyway back to this building here in front of us. This is where we found the Exogeny employees from the Exogeny headquarters. We're gonna have a chat with them, plus Lisbeth, who we found. Ooh! I did not mean to do that. That was pretty awesome, though. It's a good thing I didn't launch myself off of this road, because there's nothing down there. It's a long way down to the planet's surface. As soon as you fall off the skyway, bop, 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 critical mission failure. Wow, wow, wow. No, Elizabeth.
This is Juliana Bainham of Feros Colony. Please help us.
Okay.
That's my mom. Stop! Stop the rover!
Oh, there she goes. Well, this can't be good. Let's hop out. We shall investigate.
You can't do this, Jong.
Everyone shut up. Let me think.
What's going on?
You won't get away with this.
Get her out of here!
Get away from her, you son of a bitch!
Lisbeth!
Oh, great.
Damn it! Come out where I can see you! All of you! Shepard, damn it. I knew it was too much to hope the Geth would kill you.
Yep.
I found some interesting facts about you in the Exogeny database. I know what you did on Torfin. There's no reason for this to get bloody.
Not this time, Jean. You need to back down and let them go.
You don't understand. It's not that easy. Communications are back up. Exogeny wants this place purged.
This is a human colony, Jean. You can't just repurpose us.
It's not just you. There's something here far more valuable than a few colonists.
Are you going to tell them about the Thorian, or should I?
The what?
It's a telepathic life form living under Zeus Hope. It's taking control of the colonists there. Exogeny knew all along.
You won't get away with this, Jong.
So you keep saying, but nobody's going to miss a few colonists.
I'll kill you first.
You're a bean counter, Jong. I'm a specter. Tell me, how good are those odds?
Specter, it's a load of crap. There aren't any human specters. Right?
Is that really a chance you're willing to take, John?
Exogeny will send more assayers. They'll know what happened.
Tell them the Geth destroyed the Thorian.
Yeah, but the infected colonists can't be here when the company men come.
You can't just kill the colonists. It's not their fault.
If you kill only the Thorian, it might be enough to stop the infection. Maybe.
Anything hostile will be eliminated.
There has to be another way.
Maybe there is. Come and talk to me before you leave, Commander.
Just make sure there's no evidence when you're done.
Whatever.
You shouldn't be wasting time. Deal with the Thorian.
Oh yeah, I've got your data, by the way.
Any luck finding my workstation out in the ruins?
I managed to find the data and transfer it to your OSD.
That's very good news indeed. Thank you.
Just give me my credits and I'll be on my way.
You bet. Thanks for all your help, Commander.
Whatever you say. All right, let's have a talk with Juliana.
I'm glad you've decided to help us. I think there's a way to avoid killing the colonists.
You've got 1 minute.
I think you could safely use a nerve agent to neutralize the colonists.
Like a gas grenade.
Releasing clouds of nerve gas doesn't seem like a particularly good idea.
Nope.
It's not like it's weapons grade. The insecticide we use in the grow labs contains trace amounts of tetraclopine, a neuromuscular degenerator. If their nervous systems are already weakened, it may act as a paralyzing agent.
A reduced capacity concussion grenade might suit our needs.
No.
I'm not doing it.
At least take the grenades, so you have the option.
My men will keep everyone safe here. If you're going, it should be soon.
Whatever, John. Equip your grenades with the anti-Thorian gas upgrade. This will disable infected colonists without killing them.
We'll stay out of your way until you clear a path. Good luck.
Why build a colony if you don't intend to defend it? Exogeny Corps appreciates your cooperation in securing its colonial assets.
Well, I would use the anti-Thorian gas grenade, but one of my more recent polls on Twitter said, hey, the colonists on Feros act quite hostile. Should we just kill them all, or should we spare their lives? And you guys are some ruthless motherfuckers, so you said just kill them all. So that's what we're going to have to do. Oh, there's more enemies up ahead, as expected. What the? Oh my god. Another example of my illustrious driving skills. You should see me in World of Tanks. There we go. Whoa. I just launched myself right off. Oh. Goodbye. Oh, there's two armatures. I thought there was just the one. Oh man, I just lost a chunk. You make those shields. Eat it. There you go. Goodbye. Come here. And down you go. Aha! Run you over. You're almost dead. Come on. There you go. Sucker. Whoa. Alright, here we go. Good times. All right, let's get back here. Oh. What's going on here? More importantly, what is that? Thorian Creeper. You know what? This is the thing that we saw at one of the Cerberus labs on Binthu.
No amount of infection could have altered a human to that extent. I wonder what is going on here.
Kill them all.
I want a clean sweep. Nothing hostile lives to take a second shot.
We did acquire nerve grenades from Dr. Bainham. Do you want us to use them?
We don't have time to waste on these people. There's a galaxy at stake.
That's the spirit.
It is regrettable. But if you say there is no other option, that is just the way it is.
Alright. Well, we're going to have to equip some... what do we got here? Cryo-rad, medical interface, modulator, grade 5 proton rounds. Okay, well, I've got incendiary rounds on my weapons. Liara has chemical rounds on her pistol. Garrus has these tungsten rounds, so let's put on some shredder rounds for him. On his assault rifle, and that should help. Okay, we also had a level up some time ago. Increase my shotguns a little bit more. Oh, you know what I should have been increasing is my tactical armor. I'm an idiot. Yeah, a couple more level ups and I can equip the medium armor. Okay, so when I'm paying attention, we'll do the tactical armor upgrades. That way we can equip medium armor. Increase your electronics and Garrus. Let's increase your tactical armor as well. You can use some extra damage protection. That will also give him the shield boost ability too. All right, let's do this. Whoa, that's a lot of Okay, let's switch weapons. We are obviously going to need some close-range firepower right here. Not sure that was necessary. Are no match for us. Don't we just feel big and proud of ourselves? You know, it's kind of like shooting the gas bags on Eden Prime there. Pretty much harmless, no real threat to us. But you know what? We're just living the galactic dream right now. Slaughtering near helpless creatures. Alright, let's go back up to Zeus Hope. Now that we've executed the save. No, there's another save too. Perfect. More of these things. Oh god. That's an interesting trick. They get close to you and they puke on you. I wonder if it's deadly puke. It's dangerous puke. Watch out!
Enemy is everywhere!
Down. I'm gonna have to pop my barrier. Whoa. Hello. We are, if you could do me a favor, a singularity. Thank you. There we go. Oh man, these things are everywhere. Alright, I'm gonna use my brand new lift power. There we go. Oh, I missed my carnage. Oops. Here we go. Have a grenade. My shields are down again. Let's back up. And I will pop a warp on this guy. Hit this guy with a throw. And I am going to have to pop an adrenaline burst so I can get my barrier back. There we go. Barrier. And shield boost to get my shields up super high. Here we go. Hey, we got an upgrade kit here. This can't be good. Hold them all down. There we go. Okay. Closing with the shotgun. Oh, that missed? Okay.
I will destroy you!
We'll do no such thing. Nice going, yeah. Sorry, Ledra. You're the most likable one in the group, but off you go. See ya. He was the guy that gave us guns. Oh, man. Here we go. That takes care of all those people. As you can see, there are zero colonists alive because we are cruel sons of bitches that, you know, we don't take shit. Am I right or what? Anyways. Freighter crane controls. Let's lift that piece up. Oh, there we go. Looks like the entrance to the Thorian lair.
I tried to fight it, but it gets in your head. You can't imagine the pain.
Probably not.
I was supposed to be their leader. These people trusted me. It wants me to stop you, but I won't. I won't!
Okay. Well, Fidan just offed himself because he didn't want to be a slave to the Thorian. All right, so that's the piece of the freighter that was covering up the entrance. We had another level up, so tactical armor, electronics, and tactical armor. Okay, we'll kick in another save. Let's go see what this is all about. Ladies and gentlemen, I am slightly nervous. Don't know what we'll find down here. We just got a shitload of renegade points for killing all the colonists, too. Hey, that's just what we do. Do another save here. Down we go. Nope, not that way. What's this way? Okay.
All right, we just need to find this creature and determine what it... That is disturbing.
Awesome.
Nothing's ever simple, is it?
No, it's not, Mr. Shepard.
That's all right. Clever Shepard's gonna lay down the law.
It's leaking. Okay.
Invaders, your every step is a transgression. A thousand feelers appraise you as meat, good only to dig or decompose. I speak for the old growth as I did for Saren. You are within and before the Thorian. It commands that you be in awe.
That's not going to happen because I'm just going to destroy you.
You enslaved the colonists. You destroyed their minds. I don't know what Saren wanted with you, but I just want you dead.
The Thorian is a piece of this world, extending across the land and back through the ages. You can no more kill it than cut the sky. Your blood will feed the ground and the new growth.
My blood's gonna feed nothing, lady. You're gonna get knocked off the ledge. See ya. oh, God. They're everywhere. Quickly, Garrus, heal yourself. Oh, man. Well, that was interesting. It somehow crapped out an Asari. Can I shoot? Obviously not. Whoa, there's more of them! Boom! Boom! Oh, I overheated? That's not good. Down you go. Get off me. Garrus. Garrus, why can't I heal you? Oh, my frickin' metagel is still recharging. Okay.
Commander Shepard, there is something here. A growth of some kind.
Thorian neural node. Something tells me that might be important. Yeah, definitely. So that didn't feel good.
That had the desired effect, I believe. A few more and it will be severely hurt.
Perfect. Let's carry on then. This is one. Q. Arnold Schwarzenegger.
You are one ugly motherfucker.
Uh. Oh, great, there's another one. Well, that's reassuring. Sorry, clone. Okay. Liara, singularity that son of a bitch, please. Oh my god! She had biotics. Let's back off, because this is a little heavy. Stay back, guys. I don't want to get smacked by one of her biotic abilities right off the bat, eh? Oh my god, I will beat it again. Down goes Liara. To use my Unity ability and get her back up. And, okay, let's hit her with a throw. There. It didn't do anything! I don't think it did. I don't know if it did or not. Oh, okay. Liara, heal up, please. These Thorian creepers are no joke. Oh, hey, weapon locker. Tornado, Thunder, and Hammer, all grade 5. Cool. We'll have to take a look at those a little later. You are not getting close to me, buddy. Liara, if you could do the honors of hitting him with a throw, please. Boink. Off you go. That was awesome. Alright, this leaves the Thorian Creeper. You go. We got another neural node here. Okay. Down it goes. Okay. We're making progress. Just gotta not get eviscerated by this Asari clone. Okay, that doesn't wake him up. That's kind of silly. Oh well. Ooh. Oh no! This could be bad. This is gonna be really bad. Quickly, please, barrier. And, what can I hit her with? What can I hit her with? I'm gonna have to use a lift. The AR can use a singularity. Let's see if this works. Yeah, I kinda did. Like that. Garrus, if you could do me a favor and do this. I need to hit her with a throw. And can I heal yet? Nope, I need to use Adrenaline Burst. Now I can heal. Oh, she's down. Okay, it's just me right now. Oh, this could be problematic. Keep backing up and hit me with the pistol. Yeah! You go. I didn't expect that to knock him over, actually. See ya. Okay. That was frightening. Okay. Can I execute a save? Yes. Just in case. That Asari commando almost owned me, so. Can't be too careful. I'd like to heal up, but I'm just going to wait for the toxins to wear off. To wear off, and then Garrus should just self-heal. I'm out of grenades, though. Kind of spammed them a bit too much. But there's another neural node. Let's shoot it. Maybe I can hit it with a carnage. Maybe not. Creeper right here. There you go. Bye. There we go. Sweet. It's not liking that. It is not liking that one bit. Great. Oh, whoa, hello. Wake me. That missed. Quite badly, I might add. Oops. Alright, I'm just gonna stay calm, and we can get through this no problem. Sorry, clone's about to go down. Oh, down I go. Hey, we just got a level up, sweet. Kick up the barrier. Unfortunately, I don't think the shields help very much when you're dealing with these kind of guys. Because when they hit you, they just deal direct health damage. Thank you, gentlemen. And that's what squad mates are for. Ooh, a medical station. Oh, please tell me there's some metagel in here. Heavy armor human and medium armor Turian. Okay. Oh, hello. I'm so glad I switched out Garrus's ammunition for shredder rounds, because these are obviously organic enemies, and it just wouldn't be doing any good if he had the anti-armor rounds, or the tungsten rounds, whatever they were called. You go. Okay. Oh, that's the Asari clone. Yara, quickly, singularity. Oh no. I don't like where this is going. Where are you going? Back here. Garrus, if you can please sabotage, and Liara here with a warp. Down you go. See ya. That guy got a little close. That's okay. We're doing all right. What are these little things? Well, whatever. Let's not worry about it. Yeah, hopefully, Liara, because I'm kind of getting tired of getting attacked by freaking plant zombies. Oh, they did come up behind us. That sucks. Oh, damn it, down goes Liara. Okay, I need to use my Unity. Adrenaline burst. Heal up Liara really quick. There we go. Down goes the Asari clone. Boom! Plant puke, hazardous to your health. Things I learned today from playing Mass Effect. Goodbye. Right as I overheat. Wow, that was good timing. I gotta open the squad screen. what do we got? 2 points in tactical armor. And now I can equip medium armor. Excellent. Okay, so let's put one more point in electronics for Liara. Give her master overload. Excellent. And we'll put a point in tactical armor. And Garrus, now he's got shield boost. Okay, cool. So let's take a look. Can I equip medium armor? Yes, I can. There we go. Better shields, better damage protection. Just, you know, a bunch of better stuff across the board aside from tech and biotic protection. That's okay. As you can see, we look very different now because we have different armor. It's what all the cool kids are wearing. Whoa! Alright. We got one more neural node up here, it looks like. Oh, hello, Asari clone. Liara, if you could please singularity right there. Get out of here. That brought her out in the open. Worked out pretty well. Just be ready for the creepers, guys. Garrus, why do you have your pistol out? This explains things. Get your damn assault rifle out. We probably could have gone a whole lot easier if I noticed that a whole lot sooner. There you go. Are any of them getting up? Probably. I think by telling them on the mini-map. Oh, whoa! Frightening. Go. Looks like that's it. Down you go, you son of a bitch. See ya. Wouldn't want to be ya. What's going on here? Whoa, she came out of one of those sacks. Lovely.
I'm free. I suppose I should thank you for releasing me.
All right, then.
How do I know this isn't some kind of trick?
This is no trick. The Thorian is dead, and I am myself again. My name is Shiala. I served Matriarch Benezia. When she allied herself with Saren, so did I. Benezia foresaw the influence Saren would have. She joined him to guide him down a gentler path. But Saren is compelling. Benezia lost her way.
Okay.
You chose to side with Saren. So did Matriarch Benezia.
Benezia underestimated Saren, as I did. We came to believe in his cause and his goals. The strength of his influence is troubling.
Indeed.
Benezia sought to turn the river and was swept away.
Asari matriarchs are among the most intelligent and powerful beings in the galaxy. How could one fall under Saren's control?
That's a good question.
Saren has a vessel. An enormous warship unlike anything I've ever seen. He calls it Sovereign. It can dominate the minds of his followers. They become indoctrinated to Saren's will. The process is subtle. It can take days, weeks, but in the end, it is absolute. I was a willing slave when Saren brought me to this world. He needed my biotics to communicate with the Thorian to learn its secrets. Saren offered me in trade. I was sacrificed to secure an alliance between Saren and the Thorian.
Well, that's lovely. She mentioned that huge warship, Sovereign, so that's probably the ship that landed on Eden Prime at the very start of this mission.
That's what you get for trusting Saren.
Saren is quick to betray his followers and his allies. Once he had what he needed, he ordered his Geth to destroy the Thorian. Saren knows you are searching for the conduit. He knows you're following his steps. He attacked the Thorian so you could not gain the cipher.
The cipher, eh?
What's the cipher? And why did Saren need it?
The beacon on Eden Prime gave you visions. But the visions are unclear, confusing. They were meant for a Prothean mind. To truly comprehend them, you must think like a Prothean. You must understand their culture, their history, their very existence. The Thorian was here long before the Protheans built this city. Watched and studied them. When they died, it consumed them. They became a part of it.
Just give me some plain answers. Where is the cipher?
The cipher is the very essence of being a Prothean. It cannot be described or explained. It would be like describing color to a creature without eyes. To understand, you must have access to endemic ancestral memory, a viewpoint spanning thousands of Prothean generations. I sensed this ancestral memory, the cipher, when I melded with the Thorian. Our identities merged, our minds intertwined. Such knowledge cannot be taught. It simply exists.
That's what Saren was after. He's just as confused by the visions from the Prothean beacon on Eden Prime as we are, so he used the Thorian to gain this cipher and to help understand them better.
You taught Saren, you can teach me.
There is a way. I can transfer the knowledge from my mind to yours, as I did with Saren.
Try to relax, Commander. Slow, deep breaths. Let go of your physical shell. Reach out to grasp the threads that bind us, one to another. Every action sends ripples across the galaxy. Every idea must touch another mind to live. Each emotion must mark another's spirit. We are all connected. Every living being united in a single, glorious existence. Open yourself to the universe, Commander. Embrace eternity.
Okay, well, that was interesting. Comprehension sets in.
I have given you the cipher, just as it was given to Saren. The ancestral memories of the Protheans are part of you now.
Are you all right? What just happened?
All I saw were more weird visions. It still didn't make sense.
You have been given a great gift. The experience of an entire people. It will take time for your mind to process this information.
We should get you back to the ship where you can be monitored.
I'm sorry if you have suffered, but there was no other way. You needed the cipher. In time, it will help you understand the vision from the beacon.
What else can you tell me about Saren?
There is little I could tell you that you do not already know. He's powerful, he's charismatic, and he's dangerous. Once I followed him, blind to his true nature. But now I see he's leading the galaxy into an age of darkness and suffering.
I want to know more about Benezia.
Benezia was greatly respected among our people. A powerful biotic, even for an Asari. She was widely known as a teacher of philosophy and religion. She always sought the paths of peace and harmony. She joined with Saren because she hoped to turn him away from his path of destruction.
Instead, she became one of his most powerful allies.
As I mentioned before, Matriarch Benezia underestimated Saren. Be sure you do not make the same mistake.
I assure you, I don't underestimate anybody. I just put a bullet in their brain, because I'm Clipper Shepard!
Is there anything else you can tell me about the Thorian?
When the creature enveloped me, I became part of it, but I still don't truly understand it. So alien, so ancient. Its exact age is impossible to know. It measured time differently. 10,000 years of hibernation broken by a few frantic centuries of activity. Its mind was awesome, magnificent. It transcended all classification, and now it is gone.
The galaxy's a better place with that thing dead and gone.
The Thorian was a unique life form. A sentient being that lived for 50,000 years, maybe more. There is nothing even remotely like it in the known galaxy.
Nope.
I'm grateful you saved me from a life of thraldom. Yet I cannot help but feel some sorrow for the loss of such a rare and remarkable creature.
Whatever you say.
I want to know more about you.
There is nothing remarkable about me. I was merely one of Matriarch Benezia's disciples. For nearly two centuries, I followed her, learning at her feet. When Benezia revealed her plan to join Saren, she gave her disciples a choice. Only those who were willing had to follow her. Many felt her plan was too dangerous. But I believed in her. I thought she could turn Saren away from his insanity. Instead, we joined him in it.
What's this about Sovereign?
Tell me more about this ship Saren has.
Sovereign is alien. I do not know how it was built or where it comes from. Its design does not match that of any known spacefaring species.
No kidding.
It dwarfs any vessel in the Citadel or Alliance fleets. Its weapons are devastating. Its defenses virtually impenetrable. With it, Saren believes he is unstoppable.
You said Saren uses it to manipulate his followers.
The indoctrination. There is an energy about Sovereign. You feel drawn to the ship. It makes Saren's arguments more persuasive, more compelling. Spend enough time in Sovereign's presence, and you will lose yourself. There is no other way to explain it.
You were allied with Saren. For all I know, you still are. I can't just let you walk away.
Your suspicions are understandable. But you freed me from the Thorian and from Saren. I am on your side now. If you allow it, I would like to stay here with the colonists. They have suffered greatly, and I played a role in their suffering. I would like to make amends.
All right, so this is the key moment where I pulled you guys on what we do with an Asari agent working for Saren. And last I checked, the votes were slightly ahead in favor of sparing her. So we'll keep her, we'll let her live this time. Leper Shepard doesn't get to put a bullet in somebody's brain. He's so sad. Look at that. You can see the tears welling up in his eyes.
The colonists will need all the help they can get. They'll be happy to have you on their side.
Thank you, Commander. May fortune smile upon you.
All right, then.
I can't believe it. Zhong says we'll have all the money we need to keep this place running. It's because of you, Shepard. I can't thank you enough. Ships are already on their way here with supplies.
Thank you so much. Now Exogeny will pour the money in. We'll be able to rebuild and then some.
You won't recognize this place when we're done.
Right.
I will do what I can to assist the colony in this difficult time. I am ashamed of the damage done to the lives of these people.
Farewell, Shiela.
Farewell, Commander. I wish you well in your hunt.
Oh, thanks, Shiela. Hey, what the heck? I have a little marker for a quest. I already talked to you, Gavin.
Oh, thanks again. That data will be very valuable once I get out of here.
Whatever you say. All right, let's head back to the ship. We'll do the post-mission debriefing, as usual, which happens at the end of each major story mission. And after that, it'll be the end of this episode, where we say goodbye to Feros. Very exciting mission here. Interesting mystery. Right up until pretty much the very end when you go, oh, okay, that's what Saren's after. And then you fight a big alien thing that's able to crap out clones of Asari that it's engulfed, I suppose. All right, there's the Normandy. We also got a lot of equipment on this run, mostly mods that we can use on our weapons and stuff. As you can see, I'm wearing different armor now, so hopefully I have better damage protection and shield capacity now so I can survive in firefights a lot better. That's been a major problem for me so far. As you saw earlier, the Asari clone almost killed me. Alright.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
Look at your pink armor. You look silly.
Decontamination in progress.
Commander, you look pale. Are you suffering any ill effects from the cipher?
Yeah.
My brain's been scrambled like an egg. How do you think I feel?
I might be able to help you. I am an expert on the Protheans. If I join my consciousness to yours, maybe we can make some sense of it.
Nobody's messing with my head anymore. I'm sick of dealing with these visions.
I understand your reluctance, Commander. But the visions are already there. I only want to help you make sense of them. It may be the only way to stop Saren.
Maybe we can figure out what they mean.
Make it fast. Time's a waste.
Relax, Commander. Embrace eternity.
Here we go with this again.
Incredible. All this time, all my research, yet I never dreamed. I am sorry. The images were so vivid. I never imagined the experience would be so intense. You are remarkably strong-willed, Commander. What you have been through, what you have seen, would have destroyed a lesser mind.
Come on, get to the point. What did you see?
The beacon on Eden Prime must have been badly damaged. Large parts of the vision are missing. The data transferred into the Commander's mind is incomplete.
Awesome.
You sure you didn't come across any kind of clue or hint? Something we might have missed?
Everything I saw, you already know. You were right about the Reapers. The Protheans were destroyed by a race of sentient machines. I think it is obvious there is a connection between the Reapers, the Prothean extinction, and the Conduit. But I did not see anything that would help us find it.
Great.
Looks like we're back where we started.
Quite the opposite, Commander. I think my knowledge of the Protheans will prove useful before this is over. I was able to interpret the data relayed through your vision, what was there at least, but something was missing. Saren must have the missing information. Maybe he found another beacon. If we can find the missing data from your vision, I can... Oh. I am sorry. The joining is exhausting. I should go to the medical bay and lie down for a moment.
Are you sure it was the joining? I feel fine.
Yeah.
Your role in our communion is passive. I am the one who must submerge myself in your mind, drown myself in your thoughts. It is more difficult than it looks. The human subconscious instinctively resists the joining, Commander. A strong personality like yours makes it even harder.
All right.
We're done here. Dismissed.
I've sent off the Feros report, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Let's talk to them again.
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
Commander, is this some kind of game? Are you calling in a report just so you can cut us off again?
You know it.
That never gets old, does it?
No, it doesn't.
Computer, give me a real-time connection to the dreadnought Kilimanjaro. I want to speak to my mother, Exo Shepard.
Whoops.
Shepard speak. Oh, hi. I don't have time for a personal call right now. I'm on duty.
Forget it. I'm busy, too. Do you remember a Lieutenant Zabaleta from the Einstein?
Ernesto? Have you heard from him? He was one of the Marines who guarded the CIC. We shared a watch. I lost track of him after there was an incident.
He's a bum on the Citadel. He said he knew you and hit me up for money.
He? I'm sorry. You remember the Batarian raid on Mindwar in 2170? You were in high school. The Einstein's task group responded to the Mayday. The Batarians were still pulling out when the Marines hit groundside. Zabaleta was one of the first down. He was never quite the same after.
I don't understand. What happened down there?
About every abomination that a sentient being can do to another. To a slaver, a person is just another animal. And humans aren't always liked out here. We heard about corralling, culling. They'd shoot those they couldn't use, implant control devices in the skulls of those they could, without anesthetic.
He snapped after seeing what happened down there.
He tried to keep working, but it rode him. He showed up drunk on duty more and more. We couldn't always cover for him. The Alliance discharged him. Everyone knew he drank because of what he'd seen down there, even if he never talked about it. Especially because he never talked about it.
He let one experience ruin his career, his whole life.
Not everyone is as strong as you. If you see him, tell him we still worry about him. Tell him to go to the Veterans Affairs office. I have to go. But take care of yourself. You're making us proud. Kilimanjaro out.
Okay, so I didn't mean to trigger that, but I did because I thought it was a Codex entry. But that's related to the bum that we found in the Citadel who said that he knew our mom on another ship that he served. Anyways, this has been a long couple episodes here on the Feros Colony. Hope you guys found it very enjoyable and much more exciting than previous episodes. As I said, this game just gets better and better as you can carry on with the story, so hopefully we'll come across more exciting things. Follow me on my Twitter feed. I will be asking you in a couple days here which major story mission we should go do next after we encounter a couple more excursions on the Citadel, get some more gear, and maybe do another side mission or two. In the meantime, this has been Mobius Y. Thanks very much for watching. Hope to see you in the next episode. Have a wonderful night.